Have you ever pursued something that you believed was God's purpose and plan for your life? And yet when you went after it, there seemed to be a lot of roadblocks and hindrances that seemed to slow you down and almost to the point of making you stop. Now, if you are going through that, and maybe today if you are going through a similar experience, then you're not alone, because the Apostle Paul also seemed to have gone through the same thing. We read in 1 Thessalonians chapter 2 and verse 18, where Paul writes and he says, "Therefore, we wanted to come to you, even I, Paul, time and again, but Satan hindered us." So he says that Paul was trying to go through to Thessalonica to visit the believers there, but he says that time and again, Satan hindered him. The word that we see there for hinder, the Greek word there, actually gives us a couple of images that gives us some clarity about what could have happened. The first image that we see here, it's actually about a road that is so deteriorated and damaged, it's so full of potholes that progress is not possible at all. So for the one who is traveling on such a road, progress is very slow. And also it seems so impossible to continue the journey that one has to stop, turn around, and maybe find an alternate route to go to the destination. The other image that we have is that of an athletic arena, where a runner is there and he's running, and another competitor comes and alongside and elbows this runner out of the race. So that is the kind of imagery that we have here when we read that word hindered. So Paul here is talking about Satan's tactics. When we are pursuing God's plan, when we are pursuing God's purpose for our lives, and maybe there are so many things that come on the path that seem to slow down our journey and there's not much progress. And sometimes we think that, okay, maybe we're on a wrong path. Maybe we need to turn around. Maybe we need to look at another way of reaching that destination. Or sometimes, you know, something happens or someone comes along the way and really elbows us out of that journey. And these are Satan's tactics. So we need to be wise. We need to discern. And we need to understand a couple of things here. The first thing is that we need to remind ourselves about who has called us, who has commissioned us, and who has put us on this journey. It's the Lord Jesus. The second thing is to again remind us that the grace of God is far superior to anything that we might face. The grace of God, the empowering, the enabling grace of God is far superior to anything that Satan might do to hinder us, anything that Satan might do to stop us. So we need to hold fast to our confession of hope. We need to stay our course and we need to stand our ground, even when things seem slow, even when things seem difficult. Even as He leads us, may the grace of God cause us to not only endure the difficulties along the way, but also to overcome. So today, even as you go through that path of life's journey, just pray for God's grace to empower, God's grace to see you through. So let's pray. Father, we thank you, God, for this day. We thank you that your grace is more than sufficient to enable us to endure the difficulties that we have. Your grace helps us to overcome whatever we might face. And Father, we pray, even though Satan hinders us, Lord, we pray that you will cause us to rise above, that you will cause us to be victorious. We pray this in Jesus' name. Amen. Thank you for tuning in to Living Supernaturally. For more resources to strengthen your spiritual walk, please visit apcwo.org.